This is the ET6, which is the latest version of the hit-and-miss engine. I keep showing the unboxing of these, not because you haven't seen a box before, but to stress how well this manufacturer packages his products. And when something is packaged this well, I want to stress the point that when you get it, it's going to be received in good condition. Some fuel line, starter rope. And there's a thick layer of foam on top and bottom of this. And this is perfect. Nothing wrong with that. So we have the engine, piece of spare fuel line, a rope starter, and the instruction sheet. What's different about this engine is the right angle drive using these helical gears. We no longer have a governor assembly on this flywheel. And we now have this flying ball governor. This is very much like what was on some of the old steam engines. Another difference is the Hall effect sensor is mounted on the side of the cylinder. And this disc, which is mounted to an axle shaft that's driven by this helical gear, this disc has a magnet in this side. When it passes the Hall effect sensor, that triggers the spark. I have stated regarding some of the other engines from this manufacturer that these have been test run at the factory, and these are usually just hand tight. You can unscrew that. And I can see the edge of this has carbon on it. The inside is black. And if I shine a flashlight up in there, I can look up in here, and this is all black and has just a hint of carbon in there as well. So this engine has been run before it was packaged. I haven't touched this. I haven't touched the needle valve. I just unscrewed this on camera. This is a much nicer, neater looking connection for the spark plug as well. The exhaust valve has moved from down here to up on top of the head. The exhaust has moved from down here, and it blows straight out the side of the head up here. The carburetor has moved a little bit out here. It's on an extension now. The fuel tank has an improved mount, ties into the engine. This was weak on the earlier version with these screws going down into the wood. This has a 3-cell battery pack in it again. I'm going to replace one of the cells with this dummy battery so it will only have 2 dry cell batteries in it. That has worked on the previous engines, and I anticipate it will work in this one. This is the rope starter pulley on this side of the engine. Put the knot in there and wrap the rope around there. Make sure the ignition is turned on. Give it a pull. It spins this in a counterclockwise direction, which is clockwise on this side. All of these engines have turned clockwise when viewed from this side. This is the small O-ring that's used as a piston ring in this engine. It also fits the ET1 and the ETX vertical hit and miss engine. If you want to know how a hit and miss engine works, I cover that in my first video on the horizontal hit and miss. I have a video covering the fuel, what's the right fuel, what's the wrong fuel. I'm using Coleman Lantern fuel with just a hint of Marvel Mystery Oil. I don't measure it so much anymore, I just put enough in there to give it a light pink color. The oil is in the Coleman fuel to lubricate the O-ring that is the piston ring in this engine, and not so much as to foul the spark plug. There's a bearing block. has a hole drilled in it so you can put a little oil in there to lubricate this shaft that the gear turns on. And there's a hole that's drilled in here so you can get oil to the shaft as it runs through this block here. You always want to put a little oil on here for the cam follower, a little bit on the gears, on this piece that slides up and down. Anything that wiggles, moves, or turns, you want to put a little bit of oil on it. The way this works, you start the engine and it starts to accelerate, and this flying ball mechanism increases in speed, and that ball comes out here further and it blocks this collar so it can't go down any further, and it holds that exhaust valve open, and then you don't have any compression. The engine quits firing until this slows down enough to allow the exhaust valve to close again. Now you have compression again. I put fuel in the tank. I've oiled all the different places. This is going to sling a little bit of oil, so be aware of that. It does take a little bit to get the air out of the fuel line. I have not touched the carburetor. Now there are a number of pinch points in here. You certainly do not want to get your finger tangled up in this while this is running, and there's another pinch point here in some places. A little common sense, keep your fingers out of there. Like all of these, it could stand for a heavier base. It starts and runs as received right out of the box. Do you need a rope starter? No, you do not. These just keep getting better. This is the nicest running engine yet. I have this sitting in a machinist vise just to add a little weight to it. We'll try using this rope starter.